On, how about that? Well, what is it? It's a buttonhole trap. That cord there is too short to go over the end. You can't just take it off the obvious way. It comes off in a much cleverer way, which I might show later on. But it's a lovely thing. This is a practical joke, and it's a puzzle, and it's a good way of advertising yourself too, because you can put your logo on it. For instance, this one here, which the Mad Cow Company, who are now out of puzzles, but 20 years ago they were making puzzles, they made their version of it. And they grabbed you as you walked past their stand, or they grabbed your jacket, put this on it in about 2 seconds, you know, left walking down foolishly with a large, a little stick hanging down from your coat, from your jacket, and you didn't know how to remove it. Scissors, yes, but it's a much cleverer way to do it. So I went through my collection looking for other versions, and I found just recently a friend of mine had started doing the same thing with his business card, which is very nice. So that's the buttonhole trap, but he made two little holes here and threaded it through, and then with a bit of clever manoeuvring, he managed to get the buttonhole trap fixed onto his business card. I thought that was very nice. I could do it here with this one here to show you on my card. There's two holes. This is a very long pencil version, which a friend of mine gave. You've got to thread that through there like that. You've got to thread it through the top hole, and then here's a clever bit. What you've got to do is you've got to pass that over the card like that, down to the end, because the card's flexible, little bend, and there it is, trapped on the card. Very nice idea. I'll take it off again, because I'm going to put it on the next one, which is going to be the card. So you can put it on business cards as well as lapels. Also, and there's a friend of mine from Amsterdam who showed me, you can put it on cups. Would you believe? Yep. Well, the handle of the cup, you can put it on. You just thread it through here, and then pass the cord right over the top, and there it is, threaded on. And if people don't know how to do it, they think, hang on a sec, you just take this off the end and pass it over the top of the pencil, don't you? But no, it's no good. It's too short. It's already taut. The other thing to point out, this one here, which a friend of mine, Douglas Cameron, a magician from Glasgow, made it into a pencil, which is very nice. It's an extra little fillip to it. But the point about that is, I haven't yet pointed out to him, that if you're using the pencil, to make a pencil sharp, you have to shorten it a bit. And so if you go on shortening it, there comes a point when, in fact, you've shortened it beyond the cord and then it becomes a facile thing. So it's a great idea to have a pencil, but it does shorten its life a little bit. Well, there we are. That's one of those things, isn't it? Let's take this one off again. There's another version which you can use with your hands in order to emphasise how easy this trick is. You just put it through the hat of the loop there and pass this over the wrist and get it to sit there in your palm. No, it goes on the outside, I think. Yeah. Pass that through there like that, that's right. Up to the top. Through a hole in my hand and then pull this through. And the point is, if I make a little rule that I'm not allowed to separate my finger and my thumb, but keep them together. My thumb, it's now trapped, and I can't take it off the normal way, just by opening. I'm not allowed to do that. And the answer is you've got to take it back up the wrist to make it work. It makes it a lot trickier, but on the other hand, it shows people exactly how the thing is done. And the last version I've come across, which is by far the hardest, and I've done it with this one, is a friend of mine in Amsterdam showed me that if you make this sort of knot on it, which is not the same knot as I had, a much more difficult knot, it's still possible to do on your coattail, but my gosh, it's difficult. I spent about half an hour struggling to get the thing to come out of my tip, and I've really thought of the point of having to cut the thing up, but I didn't, you know, I managed to do it eventually. So a very, very nice and very versatile trick come practical joke come puzzle. And I'm going to have to go getting this off now. It's, without practice, it's not that easy, actually. I just know that you've got to walk it up the jacket. That's the trick. You've got to get the little jacket point here, and you've got to pull it so that it's sort of... and then you've got to get the end there and stick it through the hole, which is somewhere at the top there. That's right. And then you walk this up the jacket somehow. And if you... There we are. Walk it up the jacket, and you make a sort of tongue of the hole, so it's further and further away. The top of the item is further and further away from the actual end of the piece. Now there we are. If I walk that up my jacket, it's going to... oh dear, I don't think I can do this anymore. I'm getting too old for this. Oh, there we are. That's a long way up now. No, it's still not there. I've still got to get it further up. And further and further. Oh, there we are. Oh, yes, look, and some further still, and further still. And that side's got caught up somehow. It's defeated me. Anyone got scissors?